How's it going, guys? Welcome back to FM Nation. It's Jamie here, and we're back for the third episode of the second season of the Parma Resurrection. Today, we are going to be playing Reggiana, and it'll be it's a derby match. It's a home match. It's dubbed as the dell'Enza derby. If you have a wee look here on the right, the dell'Enza derby. They're not down as one of our rivals, but it is down as a derby, so it should be a big game. Looking for a high attendance at this match, and also they're only 3 points behind us in the league, so it's a must-win game. We usually don't want them drawing level with us. We want to be clawing our way back up the table. Since the last time we've seen you against the Feralpisalo, when we had the disappointing 1-0 defeat, we played Padova and we lost that game as well, 3-1, very disappointing. Roberto Insigne pulled one back 13 minutes from time, but it was nothing more than a consolation. It wasn't even a consolation really, because it was just kind of, it really meant nothing. So we played Bassano. After that, we won 3-1, a lot more convincing, a better performance. Although we were in 1-1 at half time, we came out of the traps. Flying in the second half, and Marco Dabro got on the score sheet as well, which I was really happy about. So I'm hoping he's going to be a big player for us this season. And that kind of got the ball rolling for him, because he scored another two goals another three goals in the next three matches. So 3 points, good performance. And then we played Alto Adige again, away from home against Alto Adige, and we just cannot seem to take points off of these guys away from home. They took the lead, and Marco Dabro got on the score sheet again with an equaliser. So although it was a draw, it kind of did feel like a bit of a victory, because we took a point from the jaws of defeat, which I was happy about, and Marco Dabro was on the score sheet again. We then played Pavia, and we'll show you some of the goals for this game. We'll show you the three goals, because this was a good game, because we went in at half time 2-1 down. And that's only because Insigne scored a goal just before half time. Well, a few minutes before half time. It was actually straight from kickoff, I think. From there, more or less straight from kickoff. From their second goal. So we were happy with that goal. And then we went out after half time, we'd kind of played a lot better in the second half. Insigne got a good goal. I'll show you this one here. I'll try and change the angle a wee bit, because it doesn't really do it justice, this one. There we go. Change the wrong one. close. That's a wee bit fast, that highlight, isn't it? We'll slow it down a wee bit for you. Just gonna throw in there, and it's a good crossing, and he takes on the volley and smashes it home into the bottom corner. It's a really good goal, a really good finish. I was very happy about that goal. And that actually drew us level. And then a few minutes later, Ricardo Calcagni, look at this goal, an absolute fantastic solo effort. Takes a man on, beats the same guy twice, and then just rolls into the bottom corner. A fantastic goal from Ricardo Calcagni. I'm really happy that I kept him, because he was one of the guys I was considering maybe letting go at the end of last season, but I'm happy that I kept him just for that goal alone, really. It was a bit of a Lionel Messi effort, but it didn't end there, because we conceded an equaliser kind of late in the match, which was very disappointing. I wasn't too happy about that, because I really thought we were going to take the points, and As you see, it's just a cross, and we never dealt with the cross proper. Never dealt with the cross very well. So that was kind of that felt like two. When I say that against Alto Adige, it felt like we won a point. That game felt like we lost 2 points. And then this game, Venezia. Oh my God, this is, I mean, Venezia have been the, if you've been following the series, Venezia have been the most frustrating opponent. Although we'd only played them twice, but it was just, both games I played against them, it was just mundane. There was nothing, one of the games actually had no highlights, other than the kickoff highlights and the full time highlight. One of the games had no highlights because they were so defensive, and you can see there on the right hand side that setup that they've got is just so defensive. And I changed the way that we've been playing, and we came out and Marco Dabro scored quite early on, but then they equalised 20 minutes in. And then I changed the shape. Instead of going 4-4-2, I changed it from a 4-4-2 to a 4-4-1-1. I just had Dabro up front himself, and brought Insignia back into attacking midfield, and that seemed to work a treat. Good goal from Dabro, and he got on the score sheet twice. Ricardo and Prota got a goal as well. What's happening here? Yeah, Ricardo and Prota got on the score sheet. Camiliano. So I was happy about that. And well, Calcagni, he had a good game as well. Calcagni had a really good game against him. It's just such a relief to know that I've now got a system to play against this kind of negative formation, because it's not just Venezia that's been playing that kind of system. Really, there's a few teams that have played it against us, and they've just really frustrated the life out of us when we come up against teams like that. So it was a big relief, more than anything, really, because now I know how to set up against these teams. I'm going to go with 4-4-1-1 when I play against them, and hopefully we can get the same result. I mean, for it to be 3-1 was quite convincing, really. And I think when you play against such a defensive tactic like that, and if you take the lead, it's kind of hard for them to get back into the game because they're so defensive, because they thrive on hitting you on the counter attack, you know. So really happy with that. But we'll get into the Reggiana game, we'll get into the big derby match, the dell'Enza derby. I've already picked the team, actually. We'll go and have a quick look at it, and then we'll get into the match. I've went with this formation today just because I had a look at Reggiana. I had a look at them. Where is it? They play a 4-4-2, and the reason I'm going with that instead of the reason I'm going with the formation I've went with is because this guy, Nicolas Sega, he's actually a wide playmaker, so he's not really a winger. Wide playmakers tend to drift in from the wide position into the middle, so they're more of like a centre midfielder when it comes to attacking. When it comes to the attacking side of the game, they drift in, and then they're kind of like an inside forward, but they're just a bit further back, really. So I'm going with the defensive midfielder just to counter that. That's why I went with the formation I went with. So we'll get into the game, and we'll see you at kickoff. All right. Actually, looking at Reggiana's formation here, they've sprung a little bit of a slight tactical surprise. Instead of going flat 4-4-2, they've pulled one of their central midfielders back in their defensive midfielding position. And I think they've done that because of the way we set up against Venezia the last time. Well, the way we changed the formation the last time. And we've went with, you know, we went with the attacking midfielder in the forward. We went 4-4-1-1. I think they've probably put the defensive midfielder in there to deal with that, but joke's on them because we're not playing that way in this match. Well, I hope the joke's on them. I hope this isn't some kind of tactical genius that they've come up with and predicted that I was going to set up the way that I did, and this is the way I counter in it. So, also, the defensive midfielder that I've picked, he can hopefully deal with Letizia as well if he needs to, because Letizia is actually a false nine. So I'm just gonna tell him to continue the good run. Hopefully that works. Wait a minute, have we got something right for kickoff here? No. we've got Freddie Annie. Is he going to get a shot at me? No, he's went down, it's a foul. Is that a penalty? Tell me it's a penalty. No, it's a free kick. It's a free kick. Oh, it's right on the edge of the box though. Bandini. Ah, he's put it, blazed it over. Unlucky. So we've got Bassi here, played the long ball, but it's headed away by Di Nardo. Picked up by Negri, plays it inside to Calcagni. Looks for Frediani, wide to Camiliano, crosses in. Dabro's there, oh, it's the crossbar. Ah, it's come to nothing. Marco Dabro has been cleared. Ah, unlucky there for Marco Dabro. I can see him being a really good signing for us. Another day that might have went in the back of the net. Throw in for Reggiana. Maltese back to Dondoni. Tries to play the long ball, but as yet he wins the header. Frediani tries to go wide to Negro, but Cipolla picks up. Carraro wins the tackle there. Negro inside to Frediani. Plays the ball to Dabro. Dabro back to Calcagni. Tries to go over the top, and Donaldo clears. Insignia to Dabro. Dabro gets a shot away, and it's a goal. Marco Dabro, 1-0 to Parma. Come on. Fifth goal of the season for Marco Dabro, and I can see him being a fantastic signing if he keeps his form up. Excellent start. Throw in for Di Nardo. Carraro plays it to Dabro. He's driving forward with the ball. He's driving the back line. Oh, he's made some very good yards there. He plays it back to Bandini. Bandini gets a cross in. We've got a bit of a stall. We're lagging. It's a cross in. Oh, and it's an own goal by Cipolla. Oh, what is he doing there? That is unbelievable. I'll take it. I'll take them all day long, actually. We've actually FM'd FM. We've got one shot on target and two goals. How did that happen? Maltese plays inside to Fortini. Letizia. It's a shot. Oh, it's an unbelievable shot. It's a great save by Bassi. Bandini plays it up the line to Insignia. Plays it to Calcagni inside. And it comes to nothing. Look at that. One shot on target. 2-0. They're actually FM'd there. Brilliant. Okay. I'm just going to tell them not to get complacent. Just to focus a little bit. Oh, what's going on here? There we go. I thought it was going to crash there. Thought it was going to crash. Alright, we'll get into the second half. And, well, I really hope it doesn't crash because we'll get off to a good start. So we've got Siega, Kilkenny, Fouls, don't yellow, no yellow card please. Excellent. Good call from the ref there not to pull the card out. So I brought on Carmine Masullo for Antonio Negro. Negro just, he was only playing a 6.9 match rating, so I thought, why not give Masullo a chance? He's linked up with Dabro before for goals in previous games, so hope we can do it again, maybe extend our lead a wee bit. We brought on Ricardo Improta for Marco Frediani. He's his fitness, I know his fitness is 74 there, but his match fit, he's like his match fitness was way down at 54, so we just brought him off. We've just conceded a goal. I'm probably going to go a bit more defensive here, just to try and hold on to the match, hold on to the win. But we also brought on, reintroducing Albono back into the fold after coming back from international duty. Oh, come on, don't lose another late goal. You're terrible for this. Oh, heart attack material there, absolute heart attack material. I can't believe I'm gonna have to make a tactical change here just to try and hold on to the match. Alright, so just kinda trying to hold on to possession now and trying to control the match. We're slowing the tempo right down. Tanucci heads against the woodwork. That would have been great to get a goal there. That would have wrapped the match up really, that. But now we're still on a knife edge really. Albono with throwing, plays it to Dabro, back to Insigne. Insigne with a nice ball out to Kilkenny. He's got to go wide to Bandini here, surely. Bandini gets a cross in. It's cleared. Carraro plays it wide to Albono. Is he gonna get a cross in? No, he plays it to Insigne. Insigne, what's he gonna do? Back to Kilkenny. Kilkenny, what's he doing? Plays it back to Carraro. Playing some nice possession football here. Kilkenny out wide to Bandini. Can he get a cross in? No, Kilkenny out wide. This is what I like to see. We're playing nice possession football here. Insigne. And it's a goal! Carmine Masullo. 3-1. Come on, that was nice. Very nice. Great build up play there. I'm really happy with that goal, actually. That was fantastic. Nice and patient. That's the way I like to see things, especially when we're up. There's no rush to go forward with the ball. That's got to finish the game there. Surely that's got to bury the match. That's got to put it on beyond all doubt. Surely this has got to be the final whistle here. We've got Maltese, plays it back to Spario, Sabotic, Zeki Nato, and Bandini wins the header. And Insigne picks up. He's just got to hold on it for a few seconds now, and that's going to be the match now, surely. And it is full time, and Insigne has been sensational today, and a 3-1, very comfortable 3-1 victory. A star performance from Insigne. Very happy with that. My assistant manager hasn't got a clue about motivation, I don't think. He says, I can't think of anything particular that needs addressing after that. Excuse me, I'm still carrying this cough, by the way. Unbelievable. I'm definitely going to praise them for that, the way they handled the game there. Showed character not to let Reggiana back into that. I'm going to praise Roberto Insigne for his second half heroics. Excellent. Alright, so we'll call that a day there then. Puts us up to 10th place, it looks like. And that's a good win. A good win in a derby match. 10th place, yeah. And now we're only 3 points off of the top of the table, which is very, very good. Very happy with that. Although we're 10th, but we're only 3 points behind top place. So it's always a good sign. It is early in the season, so there won't be much of a gap at this point of the season. When are we going to come back? Yeah, We're going to play, I'll play quite a few games actually. I think that we'll come back for the Coppa Italia Lega Pro second round, which is, I'm pretty sure it's the Serie C Cup, I think. Is it the Serie C Cup? Yeah, it's the Serie C Cup because Catanzaro are the holders. Yeah, it'll be the Serie C Cup. So we'll come back for the Serie C Cup against Pavia. Pavia are the team that, remember, we kind of lost our 3 points to in the second half, in the last 5 minutes. So that'll be a good game to watch. If it's anything like the last game, it'll be a good game to record. There should be lots of goals in it, hopefully, for us, not them. So we'll see you then. I'm going to play the games in between then, and we'll try and get that match recorded, and we'll try and get another one up, hopefully by Monday. I'm going to have a busy weekend, so I probably won't be able to get any more episodes up over the weekend, so it'll probably have to be Monday. Alright, so thanks for watching. Drop a wee like for us, for the victory there in the derby match. If you've not already done it, subscribe for updates for when the new episodes are out, and leave a wee comment if there's anything you want to see in the next episode. Don't forget the links for the social media, they're in the description, Twitter, Facebook, and the Football Manager community site, Tifo, which is basically Football Manager. It's basically Twitter for Football Manager players. Alright, so click on the links in the description and give us a wee follow. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.